classroom. In this module 2, convective mass transfer of our mass transfer 1 course, in the previous lecture we have discussed about what is convective mass transfer, what is the significance of turbulence in industrial unit operations or unit processes, and we have defined what is mass transfer coefficient. Right, so we have seen the difference between molecular diffusivity and eddy diffusivity, and to take into account of the effect of turbulence on the mass transfer, we are replacing the two terms, that is molecular diffusivity and eddy diffusivity, and we are rearranging the flux expression, and we combine all the terms other than the driving force into one and call it as mass transfer coefficient. Okay, so that's what we have discussed in the previous lecture, and in this lecture we are going to discuss in detail about mass transfer coefficient definition, its various units, its various symbols that are to be used with the superscript and subscript. We are going to write mass transfer coefficient. We are going to differentiate between local mass transfer coefficient and average mass transfer coefficient, and for various cases of mass transfer, depending upon the phases and depending upon the driving force choice, like whether we want to express the driving force in terms of concentration, partial pressure, mole fraction, all this, we can have different mass transfer coefficient, and it will have its respective units. Okay, and steady state diffusion, which we have considered earlier, no, the molar flux equations that we have defined for A diffusing and non-diffusive, B when with for gas phases, and equimolar counter diffusion for gas phases. We have seen again for liquids also same, A diffusing through non-diffusive B and equimolar counter diffusion. So we have even made a table for it, right? So from the table as the reference point, we are going to replace the terms to introduce mass transfer coefficient into the flux equation. Okay, well, we know that W and NA, how they are related. W is molar rate, whereas NA is molar rate per unit area. So that is the relationship between them. So we have flux equation for different cases of A diffusing through non-diffusing B, equimolar counter diffusion, and depending upon the choice of driving forces, like either you can express it in terms of CA, PA or YA for gases, or you can express it in terms of CA or XA for liquids, right? So we have derived expressions for that, and if you look at what is this, NA equal to KC into delta CA, that is this flux is, you can say to define the mass transfer coefficient. So we have defined what is mass transfer coefficient. We know that if W is the flux in terms of kg mole per second, then we can relate this to NA as NA into area through which it is flowing. So where NA is kg moles per meter square second, right? And if you multiply by the area, we'll get kg mole per seconds. Okay, so we have the concept of mass transfer coefficient. Let us say it as MTC. It comes as, it says W is proportional to driving force, and W is proportional to area. Okay, or area through which it is flowing. So if it is direction, area is perpendicular to it. Okay. And combining this, W is proportional to A into driving force. Let us say driving force is delta CA, A into delta CA. Okay. So this can be expressed as, we get W is equal to KC into A delta CA. Okay. Or you can say NA is equal to KC into delta ca. Okay, so that is the way, it is a phenomenological constant similar to diffusivity. K is again a phenomenological constant. That is mass transfer coefficient is the phenomenological coefficient. That is mass transfer phenomena constant. It is similar to heat transfer coefficient in heat transfer. Okay, so by mathematically we have what is mass transfer coefficient now. And what is mass transfer coefficient? It is the flux of A. It is the ratio of flux of A, that is molar flux of A, to the driving force. Okay, so what is the unit of mass transfer coefficient then? What will be the unit of mass transfer coefficient? The mass transfer coefficient will have the unit according to what is the driving force. You can say flux, molar flux divided by driving force. Okay, and this mass transfer coefficient, in general we have seen any transport flux, it can be momentum flux, it can be mass flux, or it can be heat flux, is a function of, or it is a ratio of driving force divided by resistance. Okay, so here also what we have is Na equal to Kc into delta Ca. Okay, where you can write delta Ca equal to 1 by Kc. So comparing this 1 to what we have is mass transfer coefficient is equal to 1 by resistance, or you can say resistance is equal to 1 by Kc, or you can say MTC equal to 1 by resistance. Okay, so mass transfer coefficient is nothing but resistance to mass transfer. Okay, now how to denote or represent mass transfer coefficients. Okay, and it can be based on phase, the phase in which mass transfer is taking place. The phase can be gas or liquid, and that is one. The mass transfer coefficient is defined based on the number one, phase, either it can be gas phase or liquid phase. Number two, choice of the driving force. So if it is gas, so we have choice either gas or liquid. For gas, we can have the driving forces either concentration C, or in terms of, we can write the driving force in terms of partial pressure, or you can write in terms of mole fraction YA. For liquid, either we will write as CA or XA, right? So these different ways we can represent the driving forces, right? So depending upon the phase and depending upon the driving force, we can write the driving forces as CA, PA, YA, CA, XA. Okay, and the third one is either the number of species moving, or you can say either it is when you have a bimolecular system of A and B, either we have A is diffusive, B is non-diffusive. This is one case, or it can be, this is called unimolecular diffusion, right? Unimolecular diffusion, UMD, or it can be equimolar counter diffusion, equimolar counter diffusion. Okay, so we have, at least right now, so far whatever we have discussed, there is 5 mass transfer coefficients available with us. Okay, for these cases, and for this 5 for this and for this, so totally we have 10 mass transfer coefficients now. Okay, this is 5, number of driving forces is 5, and this is 1 and 2, so 5 for this and 5 for this. Totally we can write 10 mass transfer coefficients. So same k only we are going to make use of. Okay, and another thing we should know is we will have individual mass transfer coefficients and overall mass transfer coefficient. So this is similar to heat transfer, individual heat transfer coefficients and H overall heat transfer coefficient. When there is more than one resistance film, okay, when there is more than one resistance film, we are going to have a resistance film with respect to one of the resistance film, or overall is based on taking into consideration of both films. Okay, so that also possible. So we can have individual mass transfer coefficients and overall mass transfer coefficients. So how to differentiate all these now? So we have 10 again for individual and overall. We are going to define another set of mass transfer coefficients. Okay, so how to differentiate them, how to denote them, what is the notation we are going to use is very important to understand. So once we are thorough with it, we can able to easily get through this module easy quickly. Okay, so I will give you tips for that. So first tip is, so there will be, we are going to make use of k, there is no doubt about this. Okay, so either in that there is small k, small letter, capital letter, we are going to make use of it. Okay, so small letter is, let me say k, capital letter k. Okay, so small letter k refers to individual mass transfer coefficients. So small letter k represents individual mass transfer coefficients, and capital K represents overall mass transfer coefficient. Okay, now so this is about division between individual mass transfer coefficients and overall mass transfer coefficients. Okay, now this k, either it is small k or capital K, we are going to make use of a superscript and subscript. That is, anything like exponent power, whatever we write, it is superscript. Whatever we write as a subscript, it is okay, subscript. So for example, it is in XA square, A is subscript, 2 is superscript. Okay, so we are going to use a superscript and a subscript for classifying to represent whether it is denoting a gas phase or liquid phase, what is the choice of driving force, either it is a UMD or equimolar counter diffusion, equimolar counter diffusion or unimolecular diffusion. So what is this, either gas phase or liquid phase, either unimolecular diffusion or equimolar counter diffusion, what is the driving force out of these 5, all with single notation we are going to represent now. So for that I will give you a clue. So in the subscript for gases, if the driving force is delta PA, that is, if you are writing it in terms of partial pressure, then the subscript will be KG. Okay, so if the driving force is delta PA, subscript will be KG. Then if the driving force is in terms of concentration, it is going to be KC. Okay, and if the driving force is in terms of mole fraction YA, then we are going to write KY. Okay, it's about subscript. And if it is unimolar, so when we don't put anything at the superscript, no superscript. So for unimolecular diffusion, no superscripts. So when we don't write any superscript to K, there is no superscript to K, then it means it is unimolecular diffusion. Okay. Similarly, if you have equimolar counter diffusion, that is Na equal to minus Nb, for such situation, again for the same driving forces of delta Pa, delta Ca and delta Ya, okay, so we are going to write Kg, Kc, Ky with a prime, okay, that is dash, Kg dash, Kc dash, Ky dash. So when there is a prime in the superscript, okay, whatever you call it as a prime as the superscript, if you use prime as a superscript, then it means that it is equimolar counter diffusion, okay, and based on the driving force we have different units. Okay, so what will be the unit of Kc? What will be the unit of Kc if driving force is this? We know that K is equal to Na by driving force, right? So the Na unit is kg mole per meter square second, and if the driving force is delta, whatever is the unit of driving force, that will come into picture here. Okay, so that means whatever is the unit of pressure, that will be the unit here, kg mole per meter square second into unit of pressure, say for example kilopascal. It can be any unit of pressure, right? So pressure is having, pressure units can be, it can be in terms of pascal, kilopascal, bar, atmosphere, mm mercury, etc., right? So that unit will appear in the bracket here. Okay, similarly, what will be the unit of mass transfer coefficient if the driving force is Ca? So if the driving force is Ca, in this here we are going to have, if the driving force is Ca, C is the unit of kg mole per meter cube, right? So if we divide this kg mole per meter square second divided by kg mole per meter cube, what we get is unit of K is meter per second. So when you have the concentration unit, the unit of mass transfer coefficient is meter per second. Okay, and what is the, what will be the unit if the driving force is delta Ya? So in the bracket what will come? If it is mole fraction, no unit, right? So only we'll write mole fraction. So the unit here will be kg mole per meter square second into mole fraction, which means there is no unit other than this. So mass transfer coefficient will have the unit of k flux, but we represent with the mole fraction so that we know that the driving force is in terms of mole fraction. Okay, so what actually, you know, if it is mole fraction has no unit, so K will have the unit of flux. Okay, but you can represent with mole fraction in the bracket. So this is the case for gases. So how many mass transfer coefficient we have defined here? We have defined Kg, Kc, Ky. We have defined for unimolecular diffusion, and we have defined Kg dash, Kc dash and Ky dash. So for gases, we have defined 6 mass transfer coefficients, okay, at least. And similarly for liquids, you can have unimolecular diffusion, okay, or you can have equimolar counter diffusion. And we know at least two driving forces. You can express it in terms of Ca. Driving force can be in terms of Ca, or it can be in terms of Xa. Okay, so what will be the symbol for mass transfer coefficient? If it is for liquids, again it is going to be Kc. It is going to be Kx. Okay, and if it is equimolar counter diffusion, it is going to be Kc dash, and it is going to be kx dash. Remember, until unless I say capital K, it is all or small k only. People used to write like this, or you can write like that. Okay, capital K, I will explicitly tell you capital K. So that is, so here whatever we are writing, these are all individual mass transfer coefficients, individual mass transfer coefficients. Okay, similarly capital K also will be defined. The only thing is the driving force will be different, which we will define later. Okay, so now the driving force is, and the driving force is CAXA. We have KC and KY, or KC dash KY. So for liquids we are defining 4 mass transfer coefficients at least now. Okay, that means individual mass transfer coefficients. Then what will be the unit of mass transfer coefficient? Again, already we have seen, for if it is a driving force is concentration, its unit is going to be meter per second. And if the driving force is mole fraction, it will have the unit of same Na, that is kg mole per meter square second, without unit, that is mole fraction. Okay, so that is how we can write the mass transfer coefficient for different phases and different driving forces and different type of binary mixture diffusion, either A diffusing through B or equimolar counter diffusion. Okay, so don't forget that if small k, small letter k is used, it is individual mass transfer coefficient, or capital K is used, it is overall mass transfer coefficient. Okay, small k represents individual mass transfer coefficients, capital K represents overall mass transfer coefficient. Same here in heat transfer, small h or capital U. Okay, small h represent individual mass heat transfer coefficient, capital U represents overall heat transfer coefficient. Okay, so these are the various driving forces we have for mass transfer coefficients. Okay, and in the previous lecture, if you get into the lecture number 4, we have already derived an expression for steady state diffusion. We have derived expression for steady state diffusion, where we have an expression, this is in the video lecture number 4, around second time of 38 minutes. We have the derivation, towards the end of the derivation we have an expression, Na is equal to Na by Na plus Nb into DABZ into C into ln Na by Na plus Nb minus Ca2 by C by divided by Na by Na plus Nb minus Ca1 by C, right? So in this general expression, this term DABC by Z, right, DAB by Z into C, this term is, if it is a turbulent flow condition, this expression can be modified to write. Okay, so we can modify this expression. So please write down this expression again from your notes. We'll proceed with that. Okay, so we'll start from here to get what is mass transfer coefficient. So what is that expression we have? We have Na is equal to Na by Na plus Nb into DABZ into C, okay, into that ln term, whatever is there, that will appear. Na by Na plus Nb minus Ca2 by C, Na by Na plus Nb minus Ca1 by C, where C is the total concentration, Ca1 is the concentration at location 1, Ca2 is concentration of the species A at the location 2. Okay, so now this term, and remember, in a fluid flow under turbulent flow conditions, this we are going to have different places will have different type of turbulence, right? The effect of, we have seen eddies will be formed, turbulence will be present, right? At a different locations, the intensity of the eddies, the size of the eddies going to change, vary, right? Because along the path, the eddy will interact with the neighbor eddies, and it will finally dissipate and disappear also, right? So we can locally we have to measure the mass transfer coefficient with respect to location With respect to location and time, we are going to have different mass transfer coefficients. So what we will be measuring is, we have to, at a particular location, we have to measure local mass transfer coefficient, which is represented as F. Okay, so that is one way of approach. Another approach is, you measure local mass transfer coefficients and write an average mass transfer coefficient. Okay, so which we'll write as K. So that is, it is an average of mass transfer coefficient at different locations. It is average mass transfer coefficient K. Okay, so local mass transfer coefficient is at any particular location individually, depending upon the nature of the local nature of the fluid motion. So we can say that this local mass transfer coefficient F is a function of local nature of the fluid motion, right? What is the Reynolds number at that location? What is the impact of the solid boundaries present nearby, right? So all that will determine that one. Okay, so that way this F is defined for a particular location. Is defined for a particular location. Okay. And as I said, we can even define average mass transfer coefficient. And this mass transfer coefficient may be due to free convection or forced convection. What is the difference between forced convection by external force? This is by just buoyancy. You see one layer, another layer by buoyancy or due to random motion, right? So that way this free convection will take place. Forced convection will take place by using any external force like stirrer is used, okay? Or if it is some fluid pump or compressor is adding energy to it, some work is done using pump, blowers, compressors or fans. So that way also there can be convection taking place. Okay, so F is used for high mass transfer rates. This is F is used for high mass transfer rates. The mass transfer is high, that time we use F, and for all our course purpose we will be using only average mass transfer coefficient. That's why we will be making use of mass transfer coefficient K, right? So I told you K with K or K dash, we use K for unimolecular diffusion, we use K dash for equimolar counter diffusion, okay? And that is the numerator. Okay, so regarding superscript and the subscript, it will be used, we will use G if the driving force is delta Pa, we will use Y if the driving force is, that is a subscript, if the driving force is YA, delta YA, we will use Y as the subscript. If the driving force is expressed in concentration, we will use C as the subscript. If delta XA is the driving force, then we will use X as the subscript. So we can have either KG, KY, KC for gases, or please note the correction, because both concentration, driving force is in concentration. For gas phase, if you are using KC, for liquid phase, we will not, if you want to, don't want to repeat KC, we can make use of KL. Okay, where if it is L for liquid, then the driving force is in terms of concentration. So concentration is the driving force. If it is in gas phase, we will write KC. If it is in liquid phase, we will prefer to write KL instead of KC. That you make note. So for both unimolecular diffusion as well as for equimolar counter diffusion, for liquid phase, the first subscripts will be L. Okay, KL or KL dash. KL for unimolecular diffusion, KL dash for equimolar counter diffusion, when the driving force is in terms of concentration for liquid diffusion. Okay. For gases, if the driving force is concentration, we use, okay, And what are the other one for? This is for unimolecular diffusion. Similarly, we can have same kg dash, ky dash, kc dash for gases, kc dash, some kx dash for equimolar counter diffusion. So this is for gases, and this is for liquids, this is for gases, this is for liquids. Okay, so if you are thorough with these notations, whatever we have learnt in first module number one, we are just replacing with this mass transfer coefficient terms, and further we will be learning the theories of mass transfer, all the interface mass transfer. But for basically, we should know what we are going to make use of this, because these notations, if someone, you have to look into the problem and understand whether A is diffusive, because unimolecular diffusion means Na is there, Nb is zero. If it is equimolar counter diffusion, you have Na equal to minus Nb condition, right? So if you understand what is unimolecular diffusion, so all the concepts we have learned in module one. That's why it's important to be thorough with whatever we have learned in module number one. So the concept we have learned in module number one, we are going to make use of it, and we are further even extending it. What we have learned is, under a stationary fluid conditions or under laminar flow conditions, molecular diffusion is applicable, whereas we are extending the same concepts to turbulent flow conditions. So that way, it is important that we are thorough with what we have learned in the module number one. Okay, so you should know that we are defining individual mass transfer coefficient and representing it as small k, and we define overall mass transfer coefficient later, which we will write with capital K. So all these mass transfer coefficients can be expressed in terms of overall mass transfer coefficient also. So each one will have correspondence with it. Okay. Now go to your lecture number 5. In lecture number 5, we have defined one expression, right? What is that?
So this also, you can tick this part. You can write this equation here. I am making tick, don't you make tick. Okay, so you're
right. Okay, so I asked you to make a table, right? For writing all the final formula that we have derived, I requested you to make a table for all the driving forces. That means for gases, you should have it in terms of, you should have it in terms of delta PA, delta CA, and delta YA. Same with equimolar counter diffusion. So totally 336 formulas. Okay. Similarly for liquids, you have to write all the formulas. Okay. So I hope you have done that part. I requested you to even share that information with me. Very few students have shared the information with me. Okay. So if you look at them, So far what we have seen is, we have seen different mass transfer coefficients based on the phase involved, based on the choice of the driving force, and whether it is unimolecular diffusion or equimolar counter diffusion, we have seen different mass transfer coefficients defined. Okay, at least 10 we have written so far, right? 3 plus 3, 6 for gas phase, 2 plus 2, 4 for liquid phase. So totally 10 individual mass transfer coefficients have been introduced to you. Okay, and I asked you the students to share this information. So if you look at it, it was sent by our student Preeta. I appreciate her efforts. You can see she has written for two driving forces. For gas phase, the driving forces in terms of partial pressure and mole fraction, she has written the equation. It can be written. I didn't tell to write for CA, but you can even add that part also. If CA is written here for gas phase, how to write the flux equation. So we have derived the expression. It's not that simply we have copied it from any textbook. Okay, so we have derived all the expressions. So this expression is derived, and whatever we obtained as the final equation, we made this table, right? So you can, similarly, another person, Rishita, also sent me the table to check it. She has also written two driving forces here. And so totally we have equations derived for A diffusing through non-diffusing B and equimolar counter diffusion, right? So Rishita, I appreciate your efforts also. And we have another student, Harsh Kumar. So he also has written the table, and he has written the table for all four cases here also. Okay, so if you look here, we have NA equal to DAB by Z rho by RT, sorry, P by RT, PA1 minus PA2 by PB logarithmic mean, NA equal to DAB by Z 1 by RT, PA1 minus PA2. Okay, so that, okay, we have these equations, right? Now we are going to extend these equations. How we have defined mass transfer coefficient? We have seen that in along with molecular diffusivity, we have eddy diffusivity also coming into picture. That's why it is difficult to measure them. We are replacing all the terms other than driving force into mass transfer coefficient. What is mass transfer coefficient? It is the resistance. It is the inverse of resistance, right? So that means numerator is driving force, denominator is resistance. In that fashion, if you compare, we are going to have a fair idea of how to write. We have already seen how to write mass transfer coefficient for different driving forces, right? We have already seen how to write the mass transfer coefficient for different driving forces. Okay, so that way, this table you please refer to from your notes. From this table, just round all the terms other than the driving force. So here PA1 minus PA2 is the driving force. So what is the remaining term? Resistance term is PB logarithmic mean into RT Z divided by DAB rho is the resistance, and inverse of resistance is mass transfer coefficient. So we can simply say that all these term is mass transfer coefficient. Here also, this is the driving force. Here this is the driving force. So we can club all the parameters other than the driving force. So that is your MTC, that is mass transfer coefficient. So if you have written for NA equal to CA term in terms of CA as a driving force of CA1 minus CA2, how it will change? CA1 is equal to PA1 by RT. So RT you are going to have extra, right? RT will come outside. I can have RT into CA1. So we are going to have these terms here, right? Already in this you have this DABP by is that RT. So that means RT will get cancelled. So you have this equation. Okay, so this term, this all the terms together is your driving force. Okay, PB logarithmic mean, we are going to have CB logarithmic mean. So that term including CB logarithmic mean, we will be having your, so I think he has written it here for this case, right, in terms of concentration, but it is for liquid, so he replaced your the terms for density. Okay, so same like here, we are going to have these terms. So all these, so similarly for liquid also, all these term can be clubbed. For this, all these term can be clubbed. So that is your mass transfer coefficient. Okay, whatever is not there, because we have NA equal to K mass transfer coefficient into driving force. Right? So other than the driving force, whatever is there, we are clubbing it to say it is the mass transfer coefficient, but we have to write the appropriate subscript and superscript, which I have explained. So if it is unimolecular diffusion, this is unimolecular diffusion case, and this is your equimolar counter diffusion case. So if it is unimolecular diffusion case, nothing will be there, no superscript, but if it is there, we have to use prime. Prime is the superscript we have to use. K dash you have to use here, all these cases. Okay, here simply it is K, but what will be the subscript? Subscript will change depending upon the driving force. If the driving force is PA, we are going to have G. Okay, so for this it is going to be KG into that one. So please write for all the cases. Okay, so for all terms, club all the terms other than the driving force and report it as mass transfer coefficient. So once we are done with this, we are thorough with what is the mass transfer coefficient defined for different phases and different type of species diffusion, either it is unimolecular or it is equimolar counter diffusion. Okay. So I will do that on the board neatly. So I repeat, we will use superscript, nothing. For unimolecular division, no superscript. Okay. No superscript if it is unimolecular diffusion. But if it is equimolar counter diffusion, we use prime. If the driving force is delta PA, we use G. If the driving force is delta YA, we use Y. If the driving force is CA, we use C. If the driving force is delta XA, we will use X. Okay. So that way, we are going to write the expression. Flux equations can be written. Please write down the flux equations. Make another table. Now I am asking, already you made a table 1. Now you make another table 2, where you are going to have expression for K. What is K? We will write. Okay, for gases. Okay, so for gases we had for molecular diffusion. Okay, and for convective mass transfer. Okay, first we will start with unimolecular diffusion. Okay. So if we start with gases unimolecular diffusion, okay, what are the three expressions we have? So we have the equation NA equal to dAB by Z, P by RT, PB logarithmic mean, PA1 minus PA2. Okay, so now if what I asked you to do, I asked you to club all these equations. Okay, so clubbing all these, we can write NA equal to, how to write this one? K, it is unimolecular diffusion, right? We are considering NB is equal to 0, NA is existing. Okay, so that means subscript should be, and the driving force is PA, partial pressure, so we are going to use G. KG, K subscript G, will dash will come? No, because it is unimolecular diffusion. NA equal to KG into PA1 minus PA2, where KG is equal to all subscript, small letters only, right? Right now we are dealing only with individual mass transfer coefficients. Okay, so we have KG equal to DABP by ZRT into PB logarithmic mean. Okay, so that is the, what is KG? We have this expression now. Okay, similarly, same unimolecular diffusion, when any, if the driving force is in terms of mole fraction, instead of PA1, how mole fraction is related to this one? Is going to be PA1 by total pressure, right? So A1 into P is equal to PA1. So P will go outside common. So we are going to have this thing, NA equal to DAB P by RT is at A1 minus A2 by OAB logarithmic mean. Okay. So this is what we had. Is it the one obtained by all the three students? Let me check. Yes. DAB by Z, P by RT, YA1 minus YA2 by YB logarithmic mean. Okay, so this, all these terms are clubbed together now to make this one. So we have to write this NA. NA is equal to, club this all the terms, NA is equal to K, driving force is YA, we will use subscript Y, and it is unimolecular diffusion, therefore it's not equimolar counter diffusion. With equimolar we have to put dash, so we move dash into, okay, so what is the driving force? YA1 minus YA2. Okay, if the driving force is in terms of this, we are going to have NA equal to C CA1 minus CA2 DAB by Z. Okay. C divided by CB logarithmic mean. Okay. So if you club all these terms other than the driving force, we have NA equal to KC into CA1 minus CA2. Okay. Where, so we have to write what is that. Okay, KY is equal to, KY is DABP by RTZ to YB logarithmic mean, where KC is equal to DAB into C divided by Z into CB logarithmic mean. Okay, so this, now we know what is KG, what is KY, and what is KC. This is for unimolecular diffusion. Similarly, we have expression for same gases with equimolar counter diffusion. What is that? Na equal to minus Nb, Na plus Nb equal to 0. So for such case also, we have derived expressions. And already in molecular diffusion, we have this table, refer to the table, what students have written. So you have made the table, Na equal to DAB by Z into 1 by RT, PA1 minus PA2. Now we are going to club all this term, okay. So we have Na equal to DAB by Z 1 by RT, PA1 minus PA2. Okay, so now what for convective mass transfer, we'll write Na equal to Kg dash. Remember, because it is equimolar counter diffusion. So here we have completed for unimolecular diffusion. Below this, we are now writing for equimolar counter diffusion. So all this mass transfer coefficient will have prime at the superscript. Kg dash into PA1 minus PA2. Okay, so that is the one where kg dash is DAB by RTZ. Okay, similarly, in terms of YA, if we want to write YA as PA1, so YA1 is equal to PA1 by P total. So P total into YA1 is PA1, so P will go outside common. So we have NA equal to DAB by P will be there in the numerator, RTZ into YA1 minus YA2. Is it what you have got? Yes, DAB, that P goes outside. So DAB P by Z RT into YA1 minus YA2. So in that also, if you take other than the driving force YA1 minus YA2, you take everything out, you can write KY dash. So NA equal to KY dash into YA1 minus YA2, where KY dash is equal to all these term together. Okay, that is DAB P by RTZ, that is KY dash. Okay. And the same can be written for concentration term also, right? So you can write that. Okay, so now we will move on to liquid. For liquids, what are the driving forces, mass transfer coefficient we can have in terms of concentration or x, right? So we can have the subscripts c and x. So for liquids, if you first take unimolecular diffusion, where N A exists and N B is equal to 0. Okay, so what is the expression you have referred to the table? So we have for liquids NA equal to DAB by Z rho by M average XA1 minus XA2 by XB logarithmic mean. Okay. You also get the same. NA equal to DAB by Z rho by M average ln 1 minus XA2 by 1 minus XA1. Actually, she has not completed the part. You can multiply by what is 1 minus XA2? It is XB2. This is XB1, right? So you can multiply and divide by XA1 minus XA2. Okay. You can write, this can be simplified to write XB logarithmic mean. Okay, that she has not completed. Please take care of it. I think he has written that. So you can have XB logarithmic mean term rho by M average DAB by Z. So this will be clubbed to make what is mass transfer coefficient for liquid phase, right? So what is the first we will write for same way, molecular diffusion and convective diffusion or convective mass transfer. Okay, from molecular diffusion I am just repeating the table. Okay, from table 1. Okay, so we have NA is equal to DAB by Z rho by M average into XA1 minus XA2 by XB logarithmic mean. Okay, so now we have to club all this term as mass transfer coefficient. So you have NA is equal to mass transfer coefficient, and this is for liquids, but it is unimolecular diffusion, so no dash. Okay, so for unimolecular diffusion, no dash, but subscript is based on the driving force X. Okay, K subscript X into XA1 minus XA2. Okay. Now, where KX is equal to DAB by Z rho by M average 1 by XB logarithmic mean. Okay, for liquids always we express concentration in terms of rho by M average. Okay, and another driving force, another flux equation is in terms of concentration also it can be written, NA equal to DAB by Z rho by M average into CA1 minus CA2 by CB logarithmic mean. Okay, so again this to be clubbed as mass transfer coefficient, but the driving force is in terms of concentration. We can write, okay, first flux equation, NA is equal to KL into CA1 minus CA2. Sometimes you can write KC just to differentiate it from, because when we already write KC, we have used it for gas phase. Okay, for liquid phase you can use KL. That correction you can make. So KL represent as easily you will identify it is for liquids, right? So in for similarly, when you used PA, we did not write KP. What we wrote is KG. Right? Similar to that, and the concentration force, it is KL. Okay. And concentration is the driving force. We write L for liquid phase rather than C. Okay. So KL is almost equivalent to KC only. Unit is going to be the same, okay, where KL is equal to the terms DAB by Z rho by M average 1 by CV logarithmic mean. Okay, so now we have defined what is K value for liquids. So this is the case for unimolecular diffusion. Next, we have in the table. In the table, we have for liquid phase equimolar counter diffusion. What is the formula we have? Please write down that Na equal to dAb by Z rho by m average into xA1 minus xA2. So combining this, we get mass transfer coefficient with prime, because it is equimolar counter diffusion. Everything has to be written with prime. K dash, K dash, K dash, K dash, K dash. Okay. So if you write it, what do you get? Okay. We have what we have is. For equimolar counter diffusion liquids, equimolar counter diffusions mean Na equal to minus Nb. Okay, so for that, we from table 1, what is the flux for molecular diffusion? Na is equal to dAb by Z rho by m average into xA1 minus xA2. So if for convective mass transfer, so this is for molecular diffusion. For convective mass transfer, you can write Na is equal to K prime. What will be the driving force is X. So it's going to be KX dash into XA1 minus XA2. Okay. So now you know the difference why dash is used, because it is equimolar counter diffusion. Up to here, it is unimolecular diffusion. Below this, we have equimolar counter diffusion. Okay, and similarly, when we write it in terms of concentration, we have Na equal to dAb by Z rho by m average. Okay, we'll have, sorry, for liquids, no, equimolar counter diffusion, we don't have anything like that. Simply dAb by Z CA1 minus CA2. So we have Na equal to KL dash into CA1 minus CA2. Here, what is KX dash and KL dash? Please write it down. KX dash is equal to all this term. Okay. That is dAb by Z rho by m average. Similarly, KL dash is equal to dAb by Z. Okay. So these are the different mass transfer coefficients terms with the superscript and subscript for different phases, different driving forces, and different type of species movement mass transfer, that is A diffusing through B or equimolar counter diffusion. Okay. We can always write the relationship between one mass transfer coefficient and the other mass transfer coefficient. Once we know the flux expression, and we have made, I request you to make a table 2 where you have all the flux expression for molecular diffusion as well as convective mass transfer, and where K values are written. Okay, so in this table 2 we have written what is KG, what is KG dash. So we can write what is the relationship between KG and KG dash. Okay, so KG is equal to dAb P by ZRT PB logarithmic mean, and KG dash is equal to dAb by RT Z. What is KG and KG dash? This is for UMD, unimolecular diffusion. We use prime KG dash for equimolar counter diffusion. Okay, so that way in this expression, this let be equation number 1, let it be equation number 2. Substituting 2 in 1, so what is that? In this dAb by RTZ is nothing but KG dash, right? So we have written here. So KG equal to dAb by ZRT into P by PB logarithmic mean is there. So in place of dAb by ZRT, you can substitute the values from the equation 2. So we get KG equal to KG dash into P by PB logarithmic mean. So the relationship is KG PB logarithmic mean is equal to KG dash into P. So that way, mass transfer coefficient for unimolecular diffusion and mass transfer coefficient for equimolar counter diffusion, when the driving force is partial pressure, is related. Okay. So if you look at the relationship between ky and ky dash also, ky is for unimolecular diffusion, ky dash, the prime is used for equimolar counter diffusion. So from the table 2 that we are making, we have ky equal to dAb by RTZ into p by yb logarithmic mean. So in that and we have ky dash equal to dAb p by RTZ. So what you can do, we let it be equation number 1, let it be equation number 2, substituting 2 in 1. So we can plug in this value here, means what you get is ky is equal to ky dash into p by yb logarithmic mean. Taking this to the left hand side, we have ky into yb logarithmic mean equal to ky dash into p. Okay, so that is the relationship between ky and ky dash. So this is for gas phase. Similarly, for liquid phase, what is the relationship between kx and kl? How these two can be related? So this is between two driving forces itself. Okay, so how these two are related, we can write the relationship where kx is equal to dAb by z rho by m average, and kl is equal to dAb by z. So we can relate these two. Kl can be plugged in here by substituting 2 in 1. We get kx equal to kl into rho by m average. So remember, this kx, kl, there is no prime. It means that these both are defined for unimolecular diffusion. So unimolecular diffusion means A is diffusing, B is non-diffusing. That is NB equal to 0. Okay. Take down this question. Identify three type of mass transfer coefficient that are commonly defined in the gas phase. Give the definition in the SI unit system. Show the relationship between them. So how can you relate three different mass transfer coefficients? Okay, we have to only club it and identify what is the multiplying factor or dividing factor to achieve another mass transfer coefficient. You can start with one mass transfer coefficient unit, multiply and divide by something, and this collectively is another mass transfer coefficient. So we can relate this mass transfer coefficient to another mass transfer coefficient by one way. Okay, so that you can practice. Start recording. Okay, I am speaking. So we have another question. Okay, so can you establish the relationship between kg, ky and kc? All are for gas phase unimolecular diffusion. Three ways we can write. So find out the relationship. So if you write the table 2, where you write for what is ky, what is kg and kc, we have equations 1, 2, 3. Okay, by comparing 1 and 2, we can find out that kg is related to ky. As if you divide ky by p, we get kg. That way ky divided by p equal to kg. And if you compare 2 and 3, that is kg and kc expressions, we observe that kg has RT term additionally to kc. So that way kg is equal to kc by RT. Okay, so that way we have a relationship between three mass transfer coefficients at kg equal to ky by p equal to kc by RT. Okay, so this way you should practice all the mass transfer coefficient definitions, respective units. If one mass transfer coefficient is given, how to convert to other mass transfer unit, because in numerical also one mass transfer coefficient may be given, but you may have to use it for another driving force, which means that you have to convert, for example, kc into ky before substituting in the numerical. So please practice them well. Okay, like practice only makes one perfect, right? So with this we'll be able to solve numericals. Okay, well, in this lecture we have discussed in detail about what is mass transfer coefficient, what is the difference between local mass transfer coefficient and average mass transfer coefficient, how mass transfer coefficient is defined for various phases like gases, liquids, or that depending upon the choice of the driving force in terms of concentration, in terms of partial pressure, or in terms of mole fraction, right? And we have seen for different flux equations, including for mass transfer coefficients for gas phases and liquid phases, or both cases like A diffusing through non-diffusing B, and equimolar counter diffusion. In all these cases, whatever equations, flux equations we have derived in our molecular diffusion, we have taken our reference table and we replaced all the terms other than the driving forces and replaced it with mass transfer coefficient to define different mass transfer coefficients based on the choice of the driving forces. And we used prime, without prime means it is A diffusing through non-diffusing B, and if you have used prime it is equimolar counter diffusion, right? So with all these concepts we will able to solve mass transfer coefficients, numericals on mass transfer coefficients in the next forthcoming lectures. Okay, thank you so much for joining my classroom. We'll continue in the next class. If you have any doubts, please contact me. Bye-bye.